please exit the way you came in and try to do so calmly? We can't have yelling and running and pushing in here. After the show, please go to thehollywoodfringe.org and give us a great review, because you're going to like the show. And if you don't, well, now relax and enjoy Edward Allan Baker's Face the Bible.
Janitors during the day.
So no medical benefits from
it's under the table stuff now until he gets his diploma from night school. At least that's what he says.
My brother-in-law is a drummer in a band.
He's got all the answers while I got the wolves and pampas.
The Peptones, you ever hear them?
The what?
Peptones.
Peptones?
Yes, they do 50s kind of flamingos, platters, Temptations. Okay, let's see. Father's deceased, mother lives in Washington Park. You were born on blah, blah, blah. Yeah, that's all right. Okay. You don't work. You didn't finish high school. Your phone number is
943-2145. 943-2145.
Jess was born here in August. She's 3 years old. Okay. Any complications during your pregnancy?
I hated it. It was real hot that summer.
Any complications during the pregnancy?
Nope.
Any complications during your delivery?
Who knows? You know, they knocked me out, they waked me up, they handed me a baby.
Uh-huh.
You got kids?
Two girls.
My stupid sister, right? And Russ was there watching and helping me breathe. And when Heather came out, me and Russ just cried at this miracle we made as one. She says, oh, Dad, you just gotta do it the way a dog does it.
She was probably referring to the panting and breathing exercise.
I said, that mean you looked it clean after it came out? My mother almost shit.
You said that in front of your mother.
We don't get along, so it don't matter.
Mrs. Campbell, dial 831. Mrs. Campbell, dial 831.
Listen, we gotta go over what you told me earlier.
About what happened?
Yeah, you said it was 10 o'clock.
Well, after 11, right? Wait, what time is it now? It's 11, is that what I said before, 10?
Uh-huh.
What time is it now?
12:35.
Shit! He isn't here yet? I bet that stupid child of a bartender gave him pass on the fucking message!
Sit down, Debbie. Now, we need your cooperation right this minute. You understand me? I heard Jess get out of bed.
Right.
Did she say anything?
She was going to the bathroom.
Did she say anything to you?
Nope.
Then what?
Then she, I heard a noise. And that was her falling down the cellar stairs.
So she opened the wrong
door. And I'll give you one guess as to who left the cellar door unlocked.
The bathroom door being right next to
the cellar door.
Mm-hmm. No lights on?
None, all dark.
So then what?
Then I ran and turned on the light in the hallway and...
Did you yell to a neighbor to help?
What? I can tell you never been down the only street.
Okay. So then you called the rescue.
Right, but before that, I put her head in the sink under the running water and she opened her eyes.
That was quick thinking.
Yeah, well, my mother used to do it to me because I used to pass out when I would cry and stuff.
So after you did that, you called the rescue?
Yep.
Okay. And then I picked up my raincoat? What is this word?
Radio. I picked up my radio.
Oh, okay, I see that radio. Okay.
I knew it was warm.
The radio was warm?
Warm out, I didn't need my jacket because I knew it was warm out.
So you picked up the radio.
Do you get that?
Don't get snotty with me, girl.
Okay, I'm pissed, all right?
I understand it.
It's been a crazy night around here.
Yes,
you better fucking get here.
He will.
I'm doing everything alone.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, I see. Okay. Listen to me now. A call has been made to a Dr. Burton. Jess is upstairs resting in pediatrics, and we're waiting to hear from him. You can go upstairs when we hear from him.
Well, how come I can't go up there now?
We're waiting on your husband to fill out a form for me, then we can go upstairs. And we have to wait for him so he can take care of all of this.
Okay. Fine.
Can I get you a soda or something?
Donuts.
The cafeteria is closed.
Got anything like candy bars or chips, shit like that?
Ginger ale, juice. Or coffee.
No soda? No Coke?
I wouldn't say Coke.
Ginger ale. You don't like me, do you?
If I judge all the characters that come in and out of here, I go crazy.
Yeah, but admit it, you don't like me, I can tell these things.
Honey, I'm a nurse.
Okay, I'm here.
Fucking tired.
What's been going on?
Fucking job. I've been doing this.
Relax! She said that's enough!
You don't go upstairs until you calm down. You understand me? Fill out this page, and I'll be back. Where you been?
I'm here.
Where you been?
Well, what are you talking about? I'm here!
I've been here on my own!
Look, I want to know about Jess, okay? You tell me right now.
They're looking at upstairs and told me she's resting, and they're waiting for some other kind of doctor to come. Okay, she fell down the cellar stairs because the door was unlocked. The fucking door was unlocked.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, our shit is right.
But what the fuck happened, Debbie? You weren't watching her?
It wasn't me who left the door unlocked.
I always lock that door, always.
Right, you forget.
Believe this.
She got up to go to the bathroom and just grabbed the cellar door thinking it was the bathroom door and went down.
Oh, fuck!
And I got real scared because at first I thought the grease ball upstairs was trying to break in and I jumped out of bed with the bat and see Jess's bed empty and the cellar door open. And I went down and in my mind I'm thinking, why isn't Freddy here? Freddy should be here!
All right, so what have they been telling you, you know?
This Nurse says Jess is resting and they've been keeping me in here like I'm a fucking nobody. Staying there was waiting for you.
You brought the radio?
So what?
What did you bring the radio for?
I thought someone might steal it, and it's the best thing I got. Anything else?
I'm just asking you, okay? I almost got killed driving over here. I mean, look at my hands, they're fucking shaking.
Did that roach in the ashtray?
And I got this cold in my stomach, you know, like it's a shiver, and you know.
Did you smoke the half a joint in the ashtray?
You're talking about getting stoned right now?
We're gonna need a buzz when we get out of here.
I don't want to talk about this shit right now. Just keep quiet for a moment if you can.
I can spell the club on you from over here.
Good.
Good.
I always lock that door.
Yeah,
okay?
Well,
I lock it because of Jess and for no other reason.
I wasn't down there.
Yeah, and I remember coming up after practice and hearing you on the phone with Kathy Martin yakking about some shit.
We weren't yakking
yeah,
about
and so
shit.
Yeah, it's shit with you and her.
I was asking her about a dentist I could see because my tooth has been leaking out gas.
Yeah, well, look in the phone book.
Oh, I can't ask my best friend about a
shit. She said, you're nothing in a troublemaker.
You sure didn't think that when she gave us a Stella for our wedding ceremony.
All right, you know what? Just forget. All right, I don't even know why I'm bringing her up. I'm just fucking nervous.
You know, Kathy Martin has done a lot for us.
Yeah, yeah. Fucking zoo.
What? Fate. What?
Your tooth still hurt?
Kinda.
Open up. Yeah, leaking gas. I never looked at the... You shouldn't eat all that junk, you know? I mean, some people in the papers and shit says it makes you do stupid stuff, and I just...
You're so sick! Are you putting me down? Putting me down! I have been through a lot tonight, with riding in the rescue and Jess and all the questions, and calling you, and trying to get through that asshole bartender, and all I hear is girls calling out your name to come to the phone. How do you think that makes me feel?
Look, I am working 3 nights a week.
And you're going to school for 3 nights.
Yes, yeah, and what have we got, Debbie? Huh? That radio and Jess.
I'm just saying, you're going around doing... And then you're on my back about everything I do. Makeup's bad for the skin. Jeans are too tight. You should quit smoking. You should go here and go there. Do this and do that. You didn't mind any of that in the 10th grade, did you? You love me in the park. You love me at the shipyard driving. You love me on my mother's couch.
What are you doing? What the fuck are you talking about?
I just want things back like before Freddie. I want me and you to go to bed and watch a TV movie and I put my head on your shoulder and I can hear the TV in my sleep and I feel you and hear the TV at the same time. I never used to be scared then.
I don't know what to say, you know? I mean, I gotta get the van fixed and
it's always been you, Freddie. And when you start, you know, acting like Mr. Smarty Pants, putting me and Kathy Martin down, I feel like you're getting ready to, you know, take off on me, right? Like my father did, and I freak. All right? I freak!
I'm not even talking about that shit right now, you know?
I mean, tonight, I needed you there.
Right.
I really did,
Look,
Freddie.
Listen, I play out in the band because it's something I gotta
do. You can do other things besides
playing out. I do other things during the day, okay? But the band is something
Girls.
I got. Are we gonna get into this shit again?
Yeah.
Fucking put a lid on it, man! My head's swimming with all kinds of shit that's been happening right now, and here you're your same stupid rap is making me nuts! But I left you to go to the club, okay? I'm driving down Route 10, and the van just starts smoking front and back, okay? And the radio don't work, and I got people driving past me giving me the finger, right? And through all that, all I can hear is your voice saying, oh, I don't care nothing about you. I hate your guts. Don't come back.
Yeah, didn't stop you from leaving.
You know, I think to myself, you know what? She should have married the guinea in Japan. Yeah. Honestly, shit, man. That's exactly what I was thinking when I was in the van and everything just started smoking. I couldn't even see the ends and nothing but smoke. Hey, look at my hands. She's thinking about it's got me shaking. Look at my hands.
I see them. They're shaking.
Shaking, right?
Why were people giving you the finger?
Because of the smoke coming in from the van.
Fucking people.
Yeah. You know? And I finally get off at this exit in the Olneyville, right? And I'm out there at that light. And these people, they just get out of the cars and they start yelling at me, you know? They're blaming me for the hole up there. Yeah, the ozone thing. They're blaming me for putting a hole in the earth, you know? It's
fuck! You was high!
No, it wasn't! No!
The smoke was coming from inside the van, you bastard!
No, it wasn't. I was straight tonight. And Debbie, come on! You know how much I hate it when we argue about dope?
Oh, yeah. Lost in Olneyville with people banging on the van saying you're putting a hole in the earth. If I or Kathy Martin said something like that, you'd have had a shake fit.
I forget it, alright? Just forget it! All I'm saying is that you should have married the guinea in Japan, and that's exactly what I was thinking when I was in the van, and, you know, everything just went crazy.
Yeah. Well, we'll see if that joint is still there.
Why don't you go check? Go on. Get out of the parking lot and take a couple of hits, why don't you?
Right.
Go get your high, Debbie, and then we'll fucking talk, okay? Go get your buzz and go get
Don't it. You fucking push
what
me!
What happened again? All right? Let me get this straight, so I know what they know.
She fell down the cellar stairs because you forgot to lock this stupid door. And I heard a noise like boxes or a box falling down the stairs. And I ran and seen the door open and put the light on, and there she was, not moving, way at the bottom. And I ran down and picked her up, and she was like, I mean, her arms and her head just kind of fell back, you know, like a dead pigeon from the road. And so I picked her up.
Dr. Guerra, pick up line 6.
I hate her!
Line 6.
Go get your buzz. I'll cover, right?
What is your problem?
Go get high, Debbie, and then we'll go see Jess, okay? Go! I mean, the joint's in the ashtray.
I'm gonna wait.
Shit, after what you've been through tonight, you need a good buzz on it, don't you think?
I've been through a lot.
Yeah, I know.
I hated being in the rescue squad.
It sucks.
You hear the sirens for someone else, you know?
Yeah, you know, and something fucked up happens.
I mean, you had the van.
Yeah, and you had to call the rescue.
I had to.
Right after she fell?
What?
When did you call?
I don't know the exact...
Right after she fell?
It was right after...
Or right after you hit her?
What?
When did you call?
When she wouldn't come to.
You fucking whacked her, didn't you?
Freddy.
You hit her.
She fell.
Why?
No!
Why? Why?
She
I've been here for an hour. They took me upstairs! I seen it myself!
She fell down the stairs!
You fucking lie about everything,
I'm
you know?
Not
you
lying.
Lie like most people tell the truth.
What do you mean you've been here for an hour?
When I got here, they fucking hustled me upstairs, okay? Okay? And they were talking to me, and the doctors and the nurses were telling me everything about you having a fit!
You've been here the whole time!
Shut up, okay?
And you didn't come in here to see
because
me.
They wanted to talk to me alone! When I got here, they fucking hustled me upstairs, okay? And I seen Jess through some glass, you know, and she looked okay to me, but You know, they turned her over and you saw the other side of her face and it was just like it was divided, you know? It was split in two. Her whole side of her face was swollen and her face was swelling red and black and her eye was closed shut because the swelling was so fucking bad and they got the stitches that was in the corner of her lip, you know? And they got this bandage that was just wrapped around her head and then they got these wires that were just glued into her head and they were hooked up to a machine and... I mean, I don't know, you know? I mean, you couldn't tell it was Jess until they turned her over and you saw the other side and that was Jess.
Don't fucking believe this.
You fucking beat one side of her face and I saw it. It ain't from falling down those stairs,
listen,
okay?
Listen to me,
look,
I didn't.
Tell the goddamn truth, Debbie. For once, just tell the truth. Okay? Because these people were nothing but garbage, alright? I mean, they see right through all this shit. You know, and I'm upstairs talking to the doctor, feeling like a complete asshole, okay? And he's talking to me about her head and
yeah,
how it's gotta be.
Right, from falling down the stairs.
Yeah, handprint was on her face, Debbie. I seen it.
Yeah, right, probably from when I was taking it in the sink. I was holding her head under the water.
Debbie,
so that she
they
would
go
open
through
her
this
eyes.
Every day. Don't you understand? It's time to stop. They're telling me that we could lose her, okay? But the state can take her away the same way the county mob lost her kids. Fuck. You know, and they're talking to me about police reports, okay? And how we gotta eventually be doing
that shit. Jess fell down the stairs after opening the wrong door to the cell.
They got this woman coming in from child services, all right? This Mrs. Campbell.
So what?
Just tell her the truth, okay? I mean, tell her you watch Jesse ain't gonna do it again.
And you and the shit you came in on, man.
All right, great. Fucking great.
What?
What do you mean, what?
What are you doing? You're the husband. You're my husband.
I'm tired of Deb. Okay? The lies, Only Street, Kathy Martin, the fires, the son of the stupid van, Route 10, the TV, I'm tired of being garbage! You know, and I just thought, you know, if I could just get you to tell the truth for once, you know, but. I mean. I'm gonna go upstairs and I'm gonna do it for you, you know? Because we might have a chance of something, because if not, we're headed straight for the telephone pole, girl. Fucking Crash City,
so
man!
You go upstairs. What are you gonna tell him? That you never hit your kid? That you never got hit? Oh, and I suppose none of the nurses hit their kids. Come on, everybody hates that kids. Kids whining, bitch, Freddie, and hey, I seen you up just good on the ass for ripping a page out of your school book that one time, right?
Did you beat her?
If I hit a butt every time I got a backhand, but fuck, who cares about that now they make such a big deal because some quack doctor writes a book and gets on TV to say some bullshit that he knows nothing about.
You gotta tell the truth?
Everybody has heard what I gotta say about it.
You've been lying since we've been in school, and you lied about Ken, about the guinea in Japan, and you lied about taking the pill, and you lied telling me that we can handle having a kid, and you lied when you and Kathy Martin was doing drugs and telling me that you wasn't.
And why is shit going down with us? Wouldn't be happening if you took that job at Cola Classic, and you know it!
I told you I am not working in a factory like my old man
Kathy did! Kathy can get you in.
I don't want to talk with this shit right now.
All the benefits and we can have nights together, right? I just always wanted to be with you and not with Chris in Japan.
Yeah, right.
So why'd I go with you then?
Because I made you! That's why!
Leave me here alone. What are you gonna do? I know you love me a lot. I know it. And you should take that job at Colin Plastics. Anthony Martin says you do good in shipping. And I just gotta see more of you, Freddie. I spend a lot of time thinking about you. That's not good, you know? And I'm holding Jess, and I'm spacing out the window to the brewery. And there was times with me and Jess at first, you know, like a first merry-go-round ride at the park. And me and you were holding it tight so she wouldn't be scared of falling. And I remember that time. But now I got Jess, but I don't feel her, right? Because I'm picturing you at some table with a girl, and then I got Jess, and then she'll drop a pacifier or hit me, and I freak, you know, and I feel like dropping it, and at the same time I feel like a piece of shit for thinking that kind of stuff, and both things hit me at once, and if there's nothing to put in the pipe, I get even more freaked, and then I think about being a mother, and all that comes to mind is my mother, and then I feel sick because I. And then I freak! On top of freak, right? I mean, it's like everything's on my head at once, and just as wanting something. And then you get into bed, and I can still smell the glove on you, and then I can't sleep, and then it's morning again, and I'm counting out soda cans to buy cigarettes. And then here comes asshole Charlie to pick you up to go clean toilets for practically no money, and the van is a dream that you get to have and do. And I don't know. I don't know what I'm supposed to do.
How are we doing in here? Listen, as soon as we get Mrs. Campbell, we can go upstairs. Honey, no smoking in here.
I'm not.
You were!
I wasn't!
Okay.
You knew he was here the whole time, didn't you?
Listen, you two. Some advice you can take a leave. When the people from Child Services get here, tell them what really happened. Don't be ashamed. If they think something's not right with your story, if they sense there's a hole in your story, they're not gonna play around. Jess will be put in the care of the state.
Did you hear what she said?
She fell down the stairs.
It was my mistake for not locking that stupid door, you know? You know, if the state don't buy that, you know, that was my fault, and, you know, shit, they gotta do what they gotta do.
Uh-huh.
Shit, I bet you're a good parent, right?
She told me she has two girls.
Wow.
Two, right?
Two. One's plenty.
Any boys?
Just girls.
Yeah, my mother, she had all boys. Six.
Imagine.
Six.
You sure you don't need more time to think on this?
I don't need more time. Let's get this over with.
Dr. Bazzara, please report to pediatrics. Dr. Bazzara to pediatrics.
Rocky Point before the Mustangs started to smoke on us. Heads out the window, smelling the ocean, right? Remember? All the band doing gigs at CYO Dances and me right up front nearest to you. God, I haven't heard you guys in so long, it's amazing. How long's it been, Freddie? When's the last time I heard you guys?
I don't know.
It's been long, I can tell you that.
You know, every year, my old man, he would come home with a dog. And it'd stay for a while, and when it fucked up, like, you know, it shit on the floor, or it barked too much, he would take it for a ride, and he would dump it. I went with him a couple of times. And I watched him drive away faster than the dog could run. And, you know, for whatever reason, the next day, he always went back to look for the dog, you know? And he never found it. And, a week or so later, he'd come home with another one.
Why are you saying that?
He always dropped them off right there in the same street, you know? And I asked him about it one time. And he told me, habit.
Freddie? Why?
Because I feel like it.
Today's gonna be the day that they're gonna give it back to you. By now you should somehow realize what you gotta do. I don't believe in anybody that feels the way I do about you now. Backbeat dude is on the street that the fire in your heart is out. And I'm sure you've heard it all before.
Face-to-face, so thank you guys so much for coming out. I really appreciate it. I'm Mike Antozzi, the producer here. Before we leave, is Alex Elliott Funk here? Where is he?
I'm sure he is. If we can just have a round of applause, this is our wonderful director. So, they say that you don't do theater to make money on it. You do it because you love it. That's something that I completely embody, and I know that all these collaborators do here too. We have some really shitty things that are happening right now over the last few days in our news narrative with those who are seeking asylum from Mexico. It's unacceptable that we live in a country where children are ripped away from their parents. And in many ways, this story that you saw here embodies that. So every dollar profit tonight is going to the Racies Foundation. It's a nonprofit that's helping to support the legal fees of those who are seeking asylum to come into this country because they need a better way of life, something that we're all privileged for right now. If you can, any dollar that you have is going to go directly to that fund tonight. We have a box that's out there. If you've already contributed, thank you. If you have a few extra dollars to support, that would be amazing. This is really for the children. So think about that. Thank you guys so much for coming.